This video is brought to you by Colorware. With tons of color combinations for several devices, Colorware makes it easy to customize your tech. Whether you want paint or a wrap, click the link in the description to get started. As a bonus, use code TEAMJJC at checkout to save 10% on your next order. Yo, what's going on, friends? It's Jonathan. Welcome back to another JC production where I deliver your daily dose of hotness. And in this video, we're going to be turning this into this. Kinda. I recently reached out on Twitter asking iPhone users what are the three main reasons that keep you from using an Android phone, and the response I got was incredible, so thank you guys for that. Basically, from what I can gather, it comes down to iMessage, AirDrop, and continuity. As a bonus, privacy, security, and also speed were mentioned. With all of this in mind, I'm going to address each one of these issues and come up with a solution that performs as good as it does on iPhone, or better. It's gonna be a challenge, but I'm mentally challenged, so I was born for this. The first thing that needs to be addressed is iMessage. For this, we're gonna need a Mac that can be run 24/7, like this one. It doesn't need to be a new Mac. It just needs to be capable of running macOS 10.10 Yosemite or later. The reason why I went with the latest Mac Mini is for other reasons not related to this video, which I'm going to cover in a separate video. We're gonna be using an app on the OnePlus 7 Pro and on the Mac named AirMessage. I'm not gonna walk through the setup process. Austin Evans did a great job on this, which I'll link in a card at the top. Make sure to watch his video or just follow the instructions on the website. They're really straightforward. That being said, if you run into any issues or you have any problems, feel free to let me know down in the comment section or hit me up on social and I'll help you out the best way that I can. On the Mac, make sure that Messages in iCloud is enabled. So check it out, you're gonna love this. I'm gonna go ahead and switch my SIM card from my iPhone over to the OnePlus 7 Pro. And then I'm gonna send a text message from my wife's iPhone over to my OnePlus 7 Pro. Boom, there it is. Now I'm gonna respond to her by shooting a quick 4K video and boom, there it is in full resolution, just like you would in iMessage. Moving on, we have AirDrop, which is a really easy fix. What you need to do is download an app named Send Anywhere on your OnePlus 7 Pro, on your Mac, on your iPad, on your Windows PC, whatever device that you want to transfer files to, download the app on. After you create an account and log in on all your devices, you can simply locate the device that you want to beam files over to, and that's it. While yes, it is a little slower than AirDrop, it works just as good. You can pay $5.99 a month for the pro features, which do give you additional features as well as faster speeds, but honestly, it's not really necessary. There's also a lot of other stuff that Send Anywhere can do, such as create a downloadable link, so that way you can send that link to someone that might be remote and not in the distance that they need to be in order to beam files over to them. It's a really cool app, it's free, and it's definitely gonna fix the void that you might have when it comes to AirDrop. Continuity is a bit tricky because this is something that Apple is really good at. They've done an incredible job with bonding macOS with iOS and creating a seamless experience. However, there are a few things that you can do to get some of the continuity back, and it's definitely going to improve the experience and make your Android device much more like the iPhone experience. So if you're not using Chrome by now, then chances are once you switch over to an Android phone, you're going to be using Chrome pretty much full time. In case you didn't know, Chrome keeps track of all of your tabs on all of your devices. That way you can easily access them on whatever device you're on. In other words, if I launch a website on my OnePlus 7 Pro, I can go over to the desktop version of Chrome on my Mac and quickly pick up from where I left off on my phone. The best thing about Chrome is the amount of extensions that are available to create a better browsing experience. With that in mind, if you want to receive notifications from your phone on your desktop, you can do it using an app called PushBullet. While it doesn't support every single app, it does give you more functionality than what Apple offers with the bond between iOS and macOS by showing you pretty much all of your notifications and giving you a chance to respond to some of them, depending on the app, of course. Finally, we have Alt-C, which is not a browser extension. This is actually a separate app that you'll have to download, but it's free. And what it's gonna do is act as a universal clipboard between your Mac and your Android device. So you can copy something from your Mac, and then it's gonna pop up in that clipboard on your mobile phone, giving you a little bit more continuity and a seamless experience. Now onto the bonus round. Just like continuity, when it comes to privacy and security, Apple pretty much has the game on lock. A way to make sure that your Android experience is secure is to use a good protection service. For this, I recommend Bitdefender's mobile security, which comes bundled with Total Security 2019, or you can purchase it separately for $14.99 a year. It scans your device on demand or whenever you download something new. It offers Android Wear protection and also website scanning. There's numerous performance enhancements within the software that's going to ensure that your device is running in tip-top shape. An example of this is Autopilot, which basically makes sure that your device is running as smooth as possible. Finally, when it comes to privacy, there's a built-in VPN, an app lock, and also anti-theft that will track your device if it goes missing. It also monitors your privacy settings to make sure that nobody has access to anything they shouldn't have access to. While I do understand it's not as seamless as Apple's offering when it comes to privacy and security, and you do have to pay extra for it, I for one think that Bitdefender's mobile security brings a lot of functionality and additional features that even Apple's built-in privacy and security settings do not offer. In fact, I use Bitdefender's mobile security on my iPhone still. Lastly, let's talk about speed. The OnePlus 7 Pro offers the fastest experience on a mobile phone, period. This of course comes down to a few different things, but mostly the higher RAM capacity as well as that 90 Hz OLED display, which is just incredible. Everything is literally as smooth as butter on the OnePlus 7 Pro, and when you compare it to the iPhone XS Max, well, the XS Max just seems underwhelming. So there you go, that's how you turn your OnePlus 7 Pro into an iPhone. While yes, they are nothing but workarounds, it's still going to help you transition from iPhone to Android. And speaking of that, the OnePlus 7 Pro isn't the only phone that you can do this with. Any Android phone running Android 6.0 is capable of using all of these apps. The only reason why I went with the OnePlus 7 Pro is because it's the fastest mobile phone on the market, plus the almond color, in my personal opinion, looks better than the gold on the iPhone. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, make sure to leave them down below in the comment section. If you're not following me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, make sure to do so, and I will talk to you iAndroid applesauce loving beautiful people in the next video.